Alright guys, we are rapidly running out of bad endings, but we still have a couple left to do. So we are back in chapter one of Yuen's Route, and we're going to go through a bunch of options we've done before, but these are the options you need to click if you want to get this particular bad ending. So I'm going to document it. Nose decided to plug up there. Document it for posterity's sake. There we go. And yeah. So, if you're following this as a walkthrough, you have everything you need to know. Basically is the idea. What am I doing with you today, Drayson? Stuff from the good end. We've done all of these now. We're gonna ask about Yuen. Okay, move through a chapter. Good. I don't think there's one or two we haven't done here. We've done this and this. Ah, this is a new one we haven't done yet. Hooray! You're the one who offered to let me ride with you.
You already said no.
Mom encouraged me to say yes.
If you're just going to force yourself, then don't bother.
Really, Spencer? I'm supposed to throw myself at your feet in gratitude for offering me a ride in a car that's supposedly half mine? Give me a break. You offered. I accepted. If you're going to be a pain about it, don't offer in the first place. He looked away, scowling.
Fine.
Well, this is shaping up well. That should have been our first clue not to go. Okay. Ah, the good option. And then the bad option for Allie. And then Danny, what am I doing with you? Hiding my secrets, as Nora does. Ooh. Okay, no smoochy smooch today. Definitely always let the brownie stay. Don't even have to look at my nose for that one. Car keys again. Not if you slept okay. That might be a future one. Do, 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 do. Another spiteful jab. Slap across the face. Brenna this time, not Drayson. No bullying Drayson. Ooh. Ah, because she stepped in who slapped us? Kara. When Kara slapped us this time. So that's why she's like, you know, stopping for doing something stupid. Okay. I was waiting to see if you'd do anything interesting after what happened this morning. Or anything stupid, depending how you look at it. Mm-hmm. Alright, Brenna. Am I looking at you? What am I doing? Where's my notes? No. Going under the bridge, ignoring Brenna. And then... trying to pry behind Ewan's back. Not inviting Shelly, which is very mean. Shelly is the cutest. Ignoring Ewan stalking me. Making a bad situation worse by refusing. Poor mom passing out. That's still so funny. Okay, Dad, do I have to control your pudding addiction again? Okay, still not doing this one yet. I will do it before this game is all said and done. Okay. And then, how did you meet Ewan's mom? Okay, prying again. Gotta keep prying in this bad ending. Okay, not stalking out of here to get a hug, which is sad. Not complimenting our boy. And then I think we're gonna desperately try to escape again. Okay, definitely ignore them. No confronting the tree lady, whatever you do. Don't offer to help your friends. Hello? I lay there face down in my pillow before I remembered something had woken me up. And maybe I should check it out. I rolled over, and there he was. That's not terrifying at all. My heart leapt to my throat in the instant before I realized the stupid short shadow was my idiot brother. Though it was dark, there was no mistaking his silhouette. He stood a few feet from my bed, unmoving but slightly stooped. His arms and legs were limp, as if he was barely able to stay upright, or like a weird marionette. I lay there, frozen, gripping the sheets, trying to find my voice. Except, I wasn't sure shouting at him was the right thing to do. Something about his posture was off. In the dark, I could just make out the dull gleam of his eyes. He looked, well, like a sleepwalker. I felt very cold as, eyes still trained on him, I pulled the sheets back and sat up. He still hadn't moved an inch. He was just standing there, staring. A silent, sinister statue. That is such a great sentence. The silent, sinister statue Spencer. Try saying that three times fast. Spencer? His head jerked up and I bit back a squeal as the sudden movement caused me to scramble across my bed, making a swipe for my phone. I crouched on the floor opposite my bed from Spencer and, with shaking hands, turned on the phone light. It bathed my room in a quivering blue glow that I turned toward Spencer. He still didn't move, not even when I shined the light in his eyes. He wasn't saying anything, but I could see his lips moving, as if he was muttering something silently to himself. I wasn't sure if I should wake him up or not. I don't know why, but I had the feeling if I made any more sudden movements, he'd be on me in an instant. There was no reason to feel that way. It wasn't like his posture was threatening. Yeah, but it's creepy as heck. It might have just been paranoia. But I was frozen with fear as we had a little staring contest. A stupid thing we'd done all the time as kids. The odds of this contest, though, felt a lot more serious. My head was pounding. Dizziness crept over me, and I found myself squinting up at him, just trying to keep my eyes open. We stayed there so long that my phone battery began to run down. It let out a soft, plaintive beep at 15%, and another at 10. I swallowed nervously, unsure what would happen when the light went out. I chanced a tiny glance at my alarm clock, just in time to see it tick over to 3 a.m. In the same moment, Spencer turned away and started back to the bathroom we shared. He shambled slowly that direction without another glance my way. Each step was strangely jerky, like he was trying to high step over a field of rakes. His head jerked from side to side. Now and then his arms flew up as if he just remembered he had them, but wasn't sure what they did. Did I look this dumb when I was sleepwalking? But my sleepwalking hadn't really been normal sleepwalking, had it? As soon as Spencer was clearly back in his room, I abandoned my post at my bed and staggered to the bathroom door, firmly locking it on my end. I stood there, still dizzy and gross feeling, trying to figure out what this meant. I highly doubted there was even the slightest chance you just happened to start sleepwalking at the same time I did. Ugh. I managed to stumble back to bed, feeling terrible. My heart was hammering faster than if I'd just run a marathon, and my head was getting worse. I was starting to feel a little nauseous as well, but I didn't want to sleep after that. I climbed back into bed, wedging myself in the top corner near the wall where I pulled my blankets protectively around myself. And I waited, watching both my bedroom door and the bathroom until morning came. I drifted off sometime after the first rays of light peeked in my window. There was no sign of Spencer for the rest of the night. Oh man, that was so creepy. That was way creepier. I don't know if I would have had the fortitude to, like, have a staring contest for that long, like Nora did. I don't know. Like, if I rolled over and my brother was, like, staring at me, I would probably scream bloody murder. I don't think it would end well. For any of us. Okay, well, that happened. That's a new fun thing. Oh no. Not again. Oh, this is going to be like the creepy episode. Delightful. I still very much remembered Spencer entering my room the night before. I really should have mentioned it to Allie, too. I don't know why I didn't. I guess with everything else that had happened, I just hadn't thought about it. But now that the house was dark and silent again, I was definitely thinking about it. A lot. Well, the doors were locked, so he couldn't get in again. And chances were I was overreacting. But then, who even knew anymore? I lay awake for what felt like ages. I had finally started to drift off when it started. I nearly jumped out of my skin when the bathroom door handle started to shake. It was slow and quiet at first before getting louder, angrier. I sat up, eyes wide and heart pounding as I stared that way. It had to be Spencer. Had to be. But it didn't sound like some sleepwalker trying to shamble around the house. That was deliberate. Angry. It stopped abruptly, and I heard the soft thud of footsteps as someone came down the hall to my bedroom door. I watched silently as the bedroom door handle rattled. So does that mean he wasn't sleepwalking last night? But he definitely hadn't been acting normally at all. And if it wasn't sleepwalking, why was he trying to get into my room? I was unnerved when the footsteps returned, and the bathroom door handle jiggled furiously again. It stopped after a few seconds to be replaced by a soft, rapid whisper. There were words I couldn't make out at all, strange, hurried, and hoarse. The voice retreated and everything went silent. What the hell is going on? I shot a quick glance at the clock and... 3 in the morning. Again. Okay, are we back? Yes, we're back now. Interesting. Allie, can you help me? This is kind of terrifying. Even came in my room one night. It was creepy. He just stared at me. And he was moving weird, like someone was controlling him, muttering to himself. All I can think of is when I was doing the same thing, but it doesn't make sense. If I was sleepwalking because I was a changeling, why is Spencer doing it? His being a changeling as well just doesn't add up. Do I care about you, Spencer, at all this time? No. Not really. Are we really gonna send Drazen in there? He's gonna be murdered. My poor baby unicorn. Come back to me. Oh no, poor Drazen. Drazen, hang in there. Okay, devotion is terrifying. Sorry for dragging you into this. I'm not gonna bring up the sibling stuff. Okay, Drazen lived. Whew. Thank goodness. I did not want Spencer creeping out poor Drazen. what did I do with the bell this time? Okay, it's still up in my room because that's smart. And no hugs for me today, thank you. You were acting like a huge jerk. Especially when you creep on me. I just sighed, hoping I could stop him before we spiraled back down that path. Look, it's not going to help anything if we mope about the past. What's done is done. And I'm not sorry I saved you back then. I just wish that fairies weren't such jerks. I mean, taking advantage of a child like that? How do they justify that kind of thing?
I'm so sorry.
I reached over and squeezed his shoulder gently. I know. So am I. Look, I should probably call Allie. If our theory is correct and Mom and Dad didn't forget all this so much as they hid it from us, Allie might know something.
That's true. I didn't think of that. If I disappear, then she should remember it. But why would she hide it all this time?
Well, if Mom and Dad hid it because they thought we were traumatized, Allie might have been told to never talk about it either. Remember, she only found out she was a witch a few years ago. At the time, she wouldn't have known anything supernatural had happened either.
I guess that's true.
But I still want to ask her about it. I'll be right back, okay? I left my phone upstairs. Okay. And probably don't run in to get Spencer. No. Okay. That's a very specific bad end. And we have to get all these answers right. So, Capitoline Wolfser. The Crown. Let me double check this one because I don't know my Macbeth as well as I should. This is a spider, absolutely. And Quince and Mince. Okay. So now we get to try out words. This is our last option for this bad ending. So we'll find out if the answer is words. It's probably neither of these. The answer is words, I think. You use them daily without working or pain, and Rule was laughing before I even finished speaking. How sad. I don't think you could have possibly gotten it more wrong had you been trying to do so.
What? No.
No! I'd been sure that was right. And this had been my last chance. I steeled my jaw and took a step back. If they were going to try to capture me again, I wouldn't go without a fight this time. Rule tipped her head back, still giving me that smug grin. What was going to happen now?
Well, you've tried hard. I suppose we can let you go. And the others.
What? She was letting us go? I shot Allie a disbelieving look.
Well, except for one.
What do you mean by that? She nodded to something behind me. I turned, eyes wide, and... Spencer! He looked up at me, and something was wrong. He looked dazed, confused. There wasn't a single flicker of recognition on his face. Rule's arms wrapped around me from behind, holding me back when I tried to run to him.
What did you do to him?
Do to him? We did nothing. He's a guest, after all. And you took so long to get here.
She leaned down, pressing her face close to my ears as she spoke quietly.
We kept him warm. We kept him safe. And when he was hungry.
No. No, no, no!
We fed him.
Fairy food? Spencer had eaten fairy food? I knew what that meant.
And now, it would be difficult for him to leave anyway.
No! Please, you can't do this!
Of course we can. You are in our land, and you abide by our laws. He ate our food, and now he'll be staying with us. So the fact that you got my little riddle wrong doesn't make a difference.
My eyes flashed angrily as I struggled out of her grip and rounded on her.
You knew! You knew when you asked the riddle that you wouldn't let him go!
Well, if you'd answered correctly, we would have released him. We still could.
He'll die if he doesn't keep eating your food!
That wouldn't be our concern anymore, would it? Of course, if he stays, he can eat his fill of fairy fruits and live a long, long life.
You can't do this! Allie, shaking with fury, flung herself at Rule, chanting something. She didn't finish it. She vanished in a flash that had me covering my eyes.
Allie! What did you do to her?
We sent her home. Trespassers are not allowed, and neither are guests who outstay their welcome. And I believe our business with you is done as well.
No!
I lunged toward Spencer, but I didn't even come close. The light swallowed me, and... I stumbled forward as the cold air hit me. My arms wrapped around nothing but air. I stood there, tears trickling from my eyes as I stared at the space where Spencer had been.
Nora? Nora, are you all right?
There was a rustle beside me, and... Ewan. It was Ewan, and he's awake. I collapsed against him, sobbing. This time, I had totally lost.
They took him! They took him! They took Spencer! How do we get him back? How?
Ewan stared down at me, bewildered. He shot Allie a confused look. She set a hand on my shoulder and squeezed gently.
Nora, what on earth are you talking about? Who's Spencer?
Oh no.
I pulled away from Ewan, staring at them both with disbelief as I rubbed my eyes.
What?
You said they took Spencer. Who is that?
He's my brother. What are you...
Allie and Ewan shared another look.
I think you're confused. You were dreaming, sleepwalking again. We were just trying to get you back home.
What? Was she... Could she not remember?
Come on.
She set a hand on my arm, but I jerked away.
Are you kidding me? How could you? How could you?
My face went slack as whatever I'd been about to say flitted away into oblivion. I felt like there was something important. I was just about to say something. Why had I been crying again? What did you say we're doing out here? I looked around, confused. We were at the edge of the forest, and from the look of the sky, it was early morning. Whoa, I'm up for sunrise? What madness is this? Allie just laughed.
Well, it was a really long night. Come on, let's get you back inside before your parents wake up.
She wrapped an arm around me as she led me back up the path to the back gate. I followed obediently, but I couldn't shake the feeling that I'd lost something. That I was forgetting something. Ewan was still close by my side as we went up, one arm wrapped around me. I leaned into him, frowning at the ground as we walked. I cast one last glance over my shoulder at the trees before I shook the feeling off and followed the others up to my house. I'd probably remember it later if it was something important. If not, then it wasn't important anyway. Oh, let me not be mad, not mad, sweet heaven. Keep me in temper. I would not be mad. I feel like we had that quote before. So I wonder if that was supposed to be the quote for that ending or not. Wasn't that the one with the tree lady? I was so curious what I feel like we did that one. And endings is what I'm looking for. Brother, my brother. Oh man, that is... Oof. I'm torn on that one. I'm torn because, I mean, obviously, I feel horrible that her brother was wrenched away from her. But at the same time, it's almost a kindness that she doesn't remember. And it doesn't seem like Spencer does either. So at least there's not... I mean, there's probably always going to be this sense of something's not quite right and something is missing, but the grief isn't there to mourn what was lost, nor the anger. So, yeah, man, it's a kindness in a way, but also a kindness that was done because of something terrible. You know what I mean? So I'm just like, oof. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Okay, so that was... I mean, we had a Spencer-related ending that did not result in him murdering us, so that's a plus. I like that. Let's see, we've only got two more endings left, so I don't know if the next one's going to be a friendship ending or our last bad ending, but I guess we'll find out together. Until then, I will see you later.